wanted this moon face wall hanging or decor, but online it wasn't worth it, so I decided to DIY. And to my surprise, this inexpensive phases of moon DIY turned out so beautiful, I wanted to share with you guys. Mostly you'll find the supplies at home itself. So let's get started.
Take any size of cap or anything that's available at home to cut out circles of desired dimension. Depending on your choice, you can use any color chart or poster paper. So here I'm using the black one. With the help of that particular object you choose, trace out circles depending on total how many phases of moon you want in your project. As here I'll be using 7 of them, so first trace out 7 circles and 5 more circles to cover the back. You must be wondering why only 5 and not 7 more? Just wait and keep watching for your answer. Cut out all of them using a pair of scissors. Be careful while using them. Once you got all your cutouts, start arranging them. Now you have to cut out individual shapes. As I wanted 2 of the faces to be semicircle, I folded 1 circle into halves and cut them using a pair of scissors. Make sure the edges are neat. Using 1 such half, trace on another circle and cut it as well. So now we got total 4 halves after cutting just 2 circles, out of which 2 will be used as cover up. Trace with the same cap for the other crescent shape. Once cut using scissors, now use that same piece of crescent shape to trace on 3 other circles for replicating same dimension of crescent shape. So we got total 4 of them, as 2 will be used as cover up. As per your wish, keep varying the position of cap for many different crescent shapes. Keep tracing and cutting them till you get all of them as per your requirement. Make sure for each phase of moon, you should have the respective piece for its cover up of the same dimension. Now you must have got your answer as to why cover the back instead of 7, I used only 5. That's because I have 2 semicircles in my project, so with just 2 circles I got my 4 pieces including cover-ups. Now arrange all the shapes and separate their respective cover-ups. Before starting to paint them, make sure the surface beneath is well protected using newspaper or plastic etc, as in the process some paint might spill. Now keep all the required pieces together and take any paint of your choice. I am using 3 acrylic colors, black, silver and white, and a brush. You can just manage with only white color, but I wanted variation similar to moon, so got all the 3. For painting the faces, I'll be using this floral foam. You can use any sponge as well. Cut the foam into a quarter using X-Acto knife and use different sides for different colors, so that paint doesn't get mixed up. If you're using sponge, wash it after use of each color. Pour any color onto foam. I'm using silver first. Spread it using a brush and just randomly dab onto the pieces. Keep alternating with other color like white and repeat dabbing the same way we did with silver. Keep using silver and white back and forth. Don't worry if at times there's a big blot of any paint. That's when our black paint will come into picture as a savior. I know you must have wondered why I picked a black paint when it won't be seen on a same background paper. See for yourself how important is this black paint. That's why among all paints, choose at least one paint same as the background paper, which will correct if there's any excess of any color at any particular area. Now let it dry for 10-15 minutes. And then arrange it the way you want to hang. For hanging it, you can use any transparent clear nylon string or any decorative string as per your wish. I used this cotton twine as I already had it, and it even matched the color of the wall, which won't be visible from far. Set all the pieces upside down in the same manner. Use pieces of clear tape to attach the string or twine to the respective pieces. Keep in mind the side the crescent shape is facing from behind will reverse when you will hang them. So make sure you arrange the shapes accordingly. For example, if you want the moon to finally hang towards left, Then while attaching with string, you have to place it facing right. So when all the pieces are attached, you can either use it straight away as I did it back then, as the back won't be seen. So you don't need the cover pieces in this case. But as this one I'm gifting it to my friend, I will cover it up from behind as well to give it a neat look from all sides. For this, use glue stick or any liquid glue like Mod Podge on the cover up pieces and place it firmly over the respective faces. When all the pieces are glued and covered properly, it's done. But no, I have something else as well. One more idea struck me while I was making it for my friend. By using a different color poster paper to cover up, we can use it both ways and switch it whenever we want to match it with our decor for the season or for any other special occasion. Once you get the other color poster paper, like here I'm using a white one, repeat the entire procedure as we did for the black one. Only difference here, we'll use three different acrylic colors of golden, copper and white, and then use these pieces as the cover up. Now you can either leave it simple as it is or use any decorative pendants for added look. I just use the wooden beads which I already had. Push them at the end of a brush that would help in painting. Now paint them with the same colors used for the faces and let it dry. As mine was different on both the sides, I painted in half-half ratio, black copper, golden silver and one full white, so that I can twist the bead and use it as per the decor. Just narrow down the twine's end to guide it through the hole. If you have a long needle, you can use it. If it doesn't get through, use something pointed and thin, as I used a pen's refill to push it through. Tie two overlap knots at each bead so that beads can only twist at that point but not move up or down. At the end, make a bigger knot to hold everything together. When it's done, hang it the way you want, either horizontal or vertical. In any way, it will very well merge into any modern decor or can even add a bohemian touch to the overall decor.
And if you enjoyed this video, do give it a big thumbs up. And those who are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to know more about me, do follow me on my social media. Details will be in the description box below. Thank you for watching. Till next time, take care. See you again.